Chlamydia is often referred to as a silent sexually transmitted disease, and that's because most people have no symptoms. But it can lead to serious health problems if you leave it untreated, and that's why it's important to get treated and tested early. What do you need to know about why chlamydia happens? Well, chlamydia is caused by a bacteria that spreads when you have intimate sexual contact. It's important to remember it can infect both men and women. It usually affects your reproductive organs and can lead to problems with fertility later on if you leave it untreated. You can get chlamydia from unprotected vaginal, anal, and oral sex. Chlamydia. In today's video, we're going to be discussing one of the most common sexually transmitted infections in the world. Let's dive right in and learn more about this infection. My name is Dr. Anne, and I'll go through what you need to know about this infection. Where does chlamydia come from, and can you get chlamydia without having sex? To become infected with chlamydia, you need to have intimate sexual contact, but that doesn't always involve penetrative sex. You can also get that from intimate sexual contact, so when your genitals come into contact with your partner's genitals. It's useful to remember that in men, you don't always have to ejaculate to pass on the infection. You can also pass on the infection in pre-cum or pre-ejaculate, and that's a small amount of fluid that comes out when you're turned on. You might be wondering, can you get chlamydia from a toilet seat or from kissing? Well, it's useful to know you don't get chlamydia from objects like a toilet seat or from kissing. And if you're trying to work out where chlamydia came from, remember that you could have been infected for a while and had no symptoms, so it's usually very difficult to work out when you picked up the infection. Who's at risk of chlamydia? Well, if you're sexually active, you might be at risk of chlamydia, and that includes if you're in an exclusive relationship, unless you've both been tested before you went exclusive. And that's because it's often silent and you might have had the infection at the start of the relationship. If you do get chlamydia symptoms, remember that they can be different in both men and women. They usually arrive around 1 to 3 weeks after having unprotected sex with someone who has the infection. And some people don't get symptoms till months or years later. Chlamydia symptoms in women, and what does it look like? You might not know you have chlamydia as you can't tell by looking. Some symptoms you might get are vaginal discharge, abnormal bleeding, painful sex, abdominal pain, and burning and stinging when you pee. Chlamydia in men, up to 70% of men with chlamydia usually have no symptoms, but if you do have symptoms, you might get burning or pain when you pee, pain or tenderness in your testicles, or discharge from your penis. Can you get chlamydia symptoms in your bottom, your eyes, or your throat? Well, some people do get chlamydia symptoms in those areas. They're not typically the most common areas. Women and men can pick up chlamydia infections in their anus, but this usually doesn't have any symptoms. You can get conjunctivitis, which is an eye infection, if your eye becomes in contact with bodily fluids that contain chlamydia. And another useful thing to remember is chlamydia can infect your throat if you perform oral sex without a condom with someone who has the infection. Does chlamydia go away? Chlamydia infections can be cleared up with antibiotics, which you get from a doctor, and it's usually simple and easy treatment. Chlamydia tests and diagnosis. The most common ways we test for chlamydia is a swab in women and taking a urine sample from a man, which we test for chlamydia. In some cases, we do test the throat or your anus, and that usually depends on where you have symptoms. What about self-test kits that you can order? Well, you can usually order chlamydia tests online, and if you test positive, you need to speak to a doctor will be able to prescribe you prescription-only antibiotics. And it's important to remember that we're doctors and we're here to support you, and we've seen many types of infections before. Please don't feel embarrassed. Chlamydia medication and cure. People often ask, is chlamydia curable? My answer is yes, but early treatment prevents long-term complications. Chlamydia antibiotics and which antibiotic is best? Treatment for chlamydia is simple, usually involving a course of antibiotics and avoiding sex for 7 days. Which antibiotic is best will depend on your symptoms, your health, and what's available in your area. You might be given a course of antibiotics for 7 days, or you might be given a one-off stat dose. If you are having complications from chlamydia, your doctor will advise you on the best treatment for you, and you might need a longer course of antibiotics. Can you get side effects from the antibiotics? Well, if you do get side effects, they're usually mild and usually settle down very quickly. But the symptoms can include nausea, stomachache, diarrhea, and in women, thrush. So when is chlamydia cured? After you finish your antibiotics and avoid sex for 7 days, your infection is usually gone. My doctor's tip, it's important to wait to have sex until your doctor says you can. And that's because you and your partner could reinfect each other. In general, that's around 7 days after you finish the course of antibiotics. In the US, you'll usually be given a follow-up test around 3 months later to make sure the infection is gone. And in the UK, we don't routinely retest people after they have chlamydia. Treating partners. If you've been diagnosed with chlamydia, your partner will also need treatment, and that's because you could both reinfect each other. So what are the long-term effects of chlamydia on your reproductive health? Well, if you leave it untreated, chlamydia can cause long-term reproductive health complications, particularly in women. Untreated infections can cause pelvic inflammatory disease, which is a serious infection that affects your reproductive organs and can lead to scarring and damage to the fallopian tubes, your uterus, your ovaries, and can lead to chronic pain and infertility. Women are also more likely to get ectopic pregnancies, and that's if a pregnancy implants outside of the uterus. Chronic pelvic pain, and that's if you get scarring or damage to your reproductive organs, which can cause chronic pain for months or years. Chlamydia can also affect the long-term fertility in both men and women, and that's because the infection can cause scarring and damage to the reproductive organs. In men, you can also develop prostatitis or epididymitis. Chlamydia can cause infections in your reproductive area, which can lead to infertility and chronic pain also in men. Well, how do you minimize your risk of catching chlamydia? Well, if you take the following steps, you can reduce your chances of becoming infected. So, using condoms every time you have sex, getting regular testing for infections such as chlamydia. Number three, if you do have symptoms like burning when you pee or unusual discharge, seeing a doctor early. Number four, don't share sex stories, but if you do, wash them and make sure that there's no chance of infections spreading from them. Are chlamydia and gonorrhea treated in the same way? While chlamydia and gonorrhea are both sexually transmitted infections caused by bacteria, but they require usually different antibiotics. However, in some cases, the doctors may prescribe you a combination of antibiotics to treat both infections if you do have both. So in summary, chlamydia is very common. It can have no symptoms, so getting tested early is very important. Number three, if you leave chlamydia untreated, it can lead to long-term complications. Number four, chlamydia is usually diagnosed with a simple and easy test. And if you are positive, it's usually a very quick and short treatment. Number five, chlamydia can be prevented if you use condoms properly and get regular STI tests. Thank you for watching.
Justin, I want to ask you, what is chlamydia?
Always wear a condom.